Hey folks, welcome back. Chris Garlock here with Michael Redmond, our latest AlphaGo Against the World. As you know, we are working our way through all 60, that's right, all 60 of these amazing games. After AlphaGo masquerading as Magister or Master played in late 2016, early 2017. Some of these you have seen before. We have actually done commentaries back when they first not too long after they first come out, but this is a whole series of shorter versions. Michael's focusing on the major points, and a big difference is that he has some AI help this time. So this is kind of fun, and fun for us, and hopefully fun for you as well. Now, today, Michael, I believe we have a new player.
Yes, today it's Park Yeonghun, and he's one of the top Korean players. So he's three-time world champion. And one of the older players in this series, like he was born in 1985. So I think maybe he's a bit younger than Guli was. But there's he's in the top handful of players as far as age is concerned. But he was still one of the top players in the world ranking too. And of course, he's a three-time world champion.
So he should have no problem handling Master, right?
Okay, let's get into the game.
Yeah.
Now, Master has the black stones. And you can see Master is playing his favorite opening still. And if White plays the 3-4 point, Black's going to play the large Shimari. And if White plays the 4-4 point, maybe Black's going to play this large Shimari. Although I think I've seen AlphaGo Master play the Karkari first too. So something like that. And if White answers, then maybe here. In the game, White immediately played a Karkari. And the Go AIs, or the computer programs we use, actually don't like White playing this Karkari. It's a tactic that human players would play when they when the opponent had a favorite opening as Black, which seems to be the case here. And so White wants to sort of change that and mess with it. And it's a move I have played a number of times. Yeah. So White's just it was a move that people would play against players who like to play, for instance, the mini Chinese. Like that would be playing here and playing here. Or otherwise, it could be playing here. This is something that people like to play. Of course, now people play the big Shimari, but in any case, if Black has a favorite opening like this, you can often see White playing this Karkari. Computer programs don't like it. And just this exchange, apparently, it's good for Black. And basically, the idea seems to be that if Black cuts here locally, it's going to be a good position for Black, slightly better for Black. Or if White plays any move in the corner, like this is the game move, even if White plays a solid connection, I think that Black is going to take the corner's point. And this is just considered too much for Black. Black is getting a lead in territory. Another move White could have played, this is supposed to be slightly better. And Black will cut here. And usually it's, in this board position, it seems to be fairly even if White plays this way. So maybe White should have played here. Usually computer programs and most humans tend to prefer to play this with Black. They think that Black has a very solid, a good position there, and that the exchange of these two stones, for instance, we could say that it was an exchange of these two white stones for these two black stones. Although they're giving White some potential forcing moves in the area, they have given Black a lot of solid territory in the corner. So I think the idea is that that exchange is supposed to be slightly bad for White. In the game, White played a hanging connection. And if we compare to the solid connection, the follow-up is going to be a bit weak. So it's probably not so good. Black plays a peep here. And at this point already, AlphaGo has, according to Karago, it's a 60% winning percentage. So that's pretty big. That's 10 points on the board.
Wow.
So if White had connected here, then Black would have a choice. Like Black could play here, and White would continue here. or black could play here and white would continue in the corner. One of these results would have been better for white. It would have been still in the 50% area for black, somewhere in the 50s, which is sort of to be expected, because I think that with katago, when it's calculating for a 6.5-point komi, it does start with black having something like 53-54%. So if it's below 60%, it's still okay. But in the game, now it's 60% for black. And white plays here. Actually, I was shown this move by my computer. I sort of like this move.
I do too.
That, if black plays a hane here, white's going to curl around.
Yeah.
In a really good position on this, on the lower side.
This is pretty cool.
If black pulls back here, then it reverts to a position where it's as if black had played the 3-3 point in the corner.
Right.
And at some point, white's going to close down on the lower side. So maybe black's going to keep on curling, and maybe like this, just because the lower side is so big. But then white would have a very nice position on the left side of the board. So I actually like this better than the game. And this is a point where, like, there were some players who played this attachment against the 3-4 point. And generally, at the time, they were considered pretty eccentric. Like, it's just so weird. It's supposed to be bad.
Yeah. But
in the case that black plays here, the direction of play for white is going to work so well that I think I like it in this board position.
Yeah. I think it's great, actually. It feels a little soft, right?
Mm-hmm. It's a bit soft. Already, like, it's... And white plays the hane here. Black plays a pincer. And nowadays, with the top human players and Go AIs, as I call them, you do see the tight pincer here. Like, pincering at a three-space pincer is also a very normal move, a common move on the left side. But there's a tendency for black to play the pincer shown here, which is just that much more strong against the white stone. It's a stronger attack. So white plays here, and this actually didn't really work because white is trying to make a moyo here, a territorial framework. It didn't really work. So like computer program was suggesting this move. And it's interesting to see how it didn't work because black's going to play this. And this exchange where black is going to create the potential to capture this stone, it's going to be extra security for the corner group, the black group in the corner. So in this position, sometimes people will have trouble when white later on plays, like black could, let's have black play something like this. At some point in the game, maybe white's going to try something like this. And it turns out this kind of move can sometimes be pretty troublesome. Usually black can kill the white stone, but it does usually lead into some kind of a squeeze, and it's troublesome for black.
Mm-hmm.
And so in the game, black plays this exchange, which superficially it looks like black has reinforced white.
Right.
But by getting this extra eye here, it makes the corner, it just, any attack against the corner is going to take two moves now. White would have to start with this move after black. Let's just give black one more move. White would have to start with this move. And then after that, you would have the potential for some kind of squeeze, and it would still just be a squeeze. It wouldn't be outright killing the black group. So it just takes that much longer for white to set that up. One extra move is one move is really important. So in the game, black invades here, and when black invades here, and the fact is that black's group in the corner, as I was saying, it takes two moves for white to set up an attack against that. So that group in the corner is perfectly secure.
Mm.
In fact, in some cases, black can even hope to cut on the sixth line here, which is far in the future, but it's not something you can completely ignore.
Wow.
And black doesn't have any weak stones except for this one stone that has jumped into white's territory. And just let's look at the whole board position. Where is white's territory? Like, it's white doesn't have any territory yet.
It's always in the upper left.
In the upper left, that's a white corner, yeah. Usually you would expect white to get some territory here, But then, like, everything else is, it sort of belongs to black. Like, all of these spaces are loosely controlled by black. It's not as if they're solid territories, but there's a lot more area that's controlled by black. So at this point, it's already 65% for black, 12 points. Let's get a bit further into the game. One thing about Park, I think he was a very steady player. So he's giving up a little bit by time, at a time. But actually, when he played here and then he played this attachment, this order just didn't work. Like, the question is this exchange going to be good for white or bad for white? And for instance, if black pulls back here, that exchange will have been a good exchange for white. This exchange here, these two black stones are a bit, they're not very efficient. They're a bit clunky. So in this case, it would be a good exchange for white. But when black curls around in the corner and captures the cornerstone, now that exchange is going to be really bad. So just let's go back a few moves and take a look at white playing the 3-3 attachment first, and then here. And something like this would have been better. And so the difference is that when black captures from the corner, when black plays this atari in the corner and spins it around like this, it's going to be that much better for white. Like, this variation is just so much better for white, in which white has a kind of a clean area here on the lower side. It's just that much better. In the game, it's like this. Black plays atari in the corner. And this exchange here, it turns out it's given black a very nice position there. It's strengthened black. And so now it's more like 67%. Jeez. It's getting pretty hopeless. I'll just show you some more moves. Like, white is forced into this low position on the second line. It's just so painful.
Yeah.
And now black has reinforced the upper. Now black has the offensive in the upper right. So that fight is going to be an attack by black. And I'll just show you a few more moves. Like, I'm probably going into a bit too much detail here. I'll just show you. There's a point later in the game where it gets something like 85%. That's pretty good. I really admired at the time the way that black is playing very lightly here, and black is prepared to sacrifice these stones, and is just building a wall on the outside here. It's working beautifully for black, and you can see black is just playing very lightly, and this whole situation where black is encircled white and made this wall here. So now black has this potential moyo on this side, and everything is pretty loosely connected. The fact that white stones here are sort of short of liberties, it means that white's not going to be able to counterattack here. So at this point, it's 85% for black. It's very, very bad. Like, white didn't get any territory after all, except for about 15 points on the lower side. So it was very slow for white. And he didn't really make any bad mistakes, but it was just the amazing play by black, amazing play by AlphaGo.
These games, and I think this is one of the reasons that we wanted to look at all 60. I mean, obviously there are some that are more beautiful than others, but just as a series, they are a really elegant series of games. I mean, there's something in each game to really admire, and also, and you've talked about this before, you know, that all of these human players, and it's been really fun, you know, learning about these different players and, you know, seeing, you know, sort of seeing them, you know, trying these different things against this, you know, sort of implacable foe, you know. You gotta kind of admire it.
Most of them are world champions, you know.
Yeah.
Especially after the first 10 games, there were some young players at first, so they're very special players. And the simplicity of the way AlphaGo does it really is what gets me. It's very, very simple, but at the same time, it's very, very deep. Mm-hmm. The way it creates these advantageous positions.
Well, folks, that'll do it for this game. Hope you've enjoyed it. Thank you, Michael. We will see you all next time. Thanks for watching.